Do you promise to respect and to obey the Diocesan Bishop and your legitimate superior?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring you to fulfill it. Do you promise respect and obedience to the Diocesan Bishop and to your legitimate superior?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfill it. Do you promise respect and obedience to the Diocesan Bishop and to your legitimate superior?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it. Respect and obedience to the Diocesan Bishop and to your legitimate superior.
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Do you promise respect and obedience to the Diocesan Bishop and to your legitimate superior?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Do you promise respect and obedience to the Diocesan Bishop and to your legitimate superior?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment.
Let us all stand for the invitation to pray.
Draw near, we pray, Almighty God, giver of every grace, apportion every order and assign every office. You who remain unchanged, but make all things new, who in your eternal providence orders all creation, makes the provision for every age. Through him is your word, your power, and wisdom. Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. For the upbuilding of the new temple, you granted the church his body should grow and spread forth, adorned with manifold heavenly graces, joined together in the distinction among its members, and fastened in unity by the wondrous bond of the Holy Spirit. And you established three ranks of ministers in sacred offices to serve you. As one, you chose the sons of Levi to minister in the former tabernacle. Thus, in the first days of your church, through the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, your sons apostles appointed seven men of good repute to assist them in the daily ministry, that they might devote themselves more fully to prayer and preaching of the word. By prayer and the laying on of hands, they entrusted with these chosen men the ministry of serving at table. We beseech you, Lord, look with favor on these servants of yours who will minister at your holy altar and who we now humbly dedicate to the office of deacon. Lord, we beseech you, send forth among them the Holy Spirit that they may be strengthened by the gift of your sevenfold grace, carrying out faithfully the work of the ministry. May every gospel virtue abound in them, unfailing love, concern for the sick and poor, unassuming authority, the purity of innocence, and the observance of spiritual discipline. May your commandments shine forth in their conduct, so that by the example of their way of life, they attract the imitation of your holy people. May they remain strong and steadfast in Christ, offering the witness of a clear conscience. By imitating on earth your Son, who came not to be served, but to serve, may they be found worthy to reign in heaven with him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. The newly ordained deacons vest themselves with a deacon's robe.
Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become, and see that you believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become, and see that you believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become, and see that you believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach.
The rites of the ordination to the diaconate culminate with the ordaining prelate, giving keys of peace to each of the newly ordained.
People of God, our newly ordained deacons. Deacon Sudoku Abadio O.A.R. Deacon Jose Prudential G. Casillo O.A.R. Deacon Giovanni Hill A. Macubos O.A.R. Deacon Jess Marco B. Sanchez O.A.R. Deacon Joseph Cyprian J. Paralida O.A.R. And Deacon Alexis P. Mansueto O.A.R.
Please be seated for the liturgy of the Eucharist.